Charming Don Charles, the leader of Team Charming. And at his side, the ever-present human hate machine, Dave Morales. What has this guy got to be so angry about? Hey, I think the name's more of a play on words. It's ironic. I don't see the hate. He's an athlete. He's a competitor. He takes out all his frustrations on his opponent, yes, but never hate. Nothing ironic about the name Human Hate Machine. This man is one horrible, hate-filled individual, and he has shown that he is indiscriminate of his hatred for others. Indeed, the only people he even seems to be able to interact with on any level are Charming Don Charles and Sadistic Jack Storm. He is here tonight to take on a man that has been a thorn in his side since day one here at SAS. Fluffy, the annoying Spud, the man that doesn't deserve to be in an SAS ring, the man that doesn't deserve to be...
Will he be serious? He was the first ever SAS UK champion by rights. He should still be holding that belt.
He should not be holding the belt. He should never have held the belt, and he won't hold it again. Trust me, John, when I say this, the human hate machine Dave Morales is closer to that title than Spud ever will be.
And these fans, they've got the measure of Dave Morales already. Look at that security guy, scared out of his wits.
Wouldn't you be, John? Wouldn't you be with this machine, this athletic destruction machine, breathing down your neck?
Absolutely, I don't want any part of the human hate machine. Dave Morales has been a fierce and successful competitor here for over 2 years in SAS Wrestling. Last month at SAS Fiction, we saw him defeat the American Jake. And this month, he is looking finally to put to bed the man that has been a pain in his neck since day one, Spud.
Armageddon comes. The war comes to an end. These two face each other for the final time as Dave Morales crushes Spud and makes sure that Spud is in no condition to face Charming Don Charles.
Well, they are facing each other for the final time. Spud versus Dave Morales. This is, for want of a better phrase, the war to settle the score. But fans, what's to say that Dave Morales is going to be victorious? You tell me, Gilligan Gordon. Spud has got just as much a chance of winning this matchup as anyone.
Well, look at the facts. Dave Morales is so much bigger than Spud, so much better than Spud, so much more powerful than Spud. He is literally a machine, not like this filthy little rodent.
But you know one thing Spud's got that's bigger than Dave Morales is? He has got a massive, a great big heart. His heart is bigger than Morales. His heart is bigger than anyone else on the SAS roster, in my opinion. He is proven. He is good to go. He never backs down from anything, and he is coming out fighting.
I refuse to say anything of the nature, because the one thing Spud's got that's bigger, the one thing that he's got that's greater than anyone in SAS, is his head. He has a massive ego, and it weighs him down.
He's got a very healthy ego, Gilligan Gordon. A healthy ego that has brought him to be the very first, the very best SAS UK wrestling champion. He beat many, many members. He beat 16 top stars. He proved his mettle. No longer should he be referred to as the underdog. No longer should he be referred to as a chancer or a maybe man. He has proved himself as one of the top stars. He could win any matchup. He is on a level pegging with any wrestler here in SAS Wrestling that you could care to put on the other side of the ring from him.
Oh, trust me, there isn't a wrestler on this entire roster that couldn't crush Spud. Every single one of them could destroy him. They could crush him. They just choose not to, because some people have heart. Some people have soul. That's the people like your Jakes and the other waste of spaces. So you take those out, and of the 16, who did he actually beat, John? Who did he beat that is worth anything to become that champion?
I'll tell you two of the people he beat. One of them was Dave Morales, and one of them was Martin Stone, and one of them was Sadistic Jack Storm.
Well, for a start, that's three people, so you completely muted your own point there. Look at the size of Dave Morales. Look at him. Yeah, how can Spud stand a chance against this man? And like you said, he's a fluke artist.
Well, that's exactly what I didn't say. I said the opposite of that. He is not a fluke artist.
No, no.
He is not a chancer. He is not even an underdog. He is not even an underdog. Don't get me wrong. He doesn't take anybody like quietly. He knows that he has to wrestle twice as hard. That just spurs him on. That just drives him on to greater things.
No, it doesn't. It drags him down and it crushes him inside. Oh, do you see the elevation there?
I certainly did. Morales showing why he is the true powerhouse of Team Charming.
Just remember, John Atkins, anytime you point the finger at someone, you're pointing three back at yourself.
Well, let's get the matchup. Let's get back to the matchup. Just take a look at Spud. He is on fire here tonight. He knows what's at stake here. He knows that if he can beat this one, he has got a great match to look forward to against Charming Don Charles. He has been desperate. He has been desperate for months to get his hands on the man who cost him his SAS UK Championship.
Oh. Spud now taking complete advantage of Dave Morales. He's taking advantage of his good nature, John.
Oh, will you be serious, Gilligan Gordon? He is doing everything he possibly can just to hold his own against a man who is much bigger than him. He has to do what he can. He has to get those chops in to come out on fire, because one kick to the midsection, one chop on Morales, and everything is turned back round. Everything's back to square one. Spud can't afford to take his eyes off the ball for even a single second.
This is delightful to watch. The size of Morales' hand is almost as big as Spud's whole chest, and he tops through him with each one of these.
Turn things around. He is coming up. Are we going to see that satellite DDT any second? He has just whipped Dave Morales. He has sent him around the ring. And fans, that was incredible. He's going to pull it off. He hooks the leg. And just a two.
I can't believe it. That wasn't even close. Why were you getting so excited, John? Spud's not going to win this match. He never wins. He can't win. He just doesn't, John.
That was incredible. That was so close. That was the Spud of old. That was the Spud who became the first ever SAS champion. And he is warming up the band. He is getting ready for that satellite DDT. Oh my, he just flung him across the ring.
Oh, Northern Lariat by Prada. That'll take your head off.
Yes, it will. He just flung the much smaller Spud across the ring. There's a cover. And Spud somehow kicking out of that one.
I can't get over how much Spud is able to take. It drives me insane that he just won't quit.
But why should he quit? He knows he's got the skill. He knows he has got the gift. He knows he has got the heart. There's something about the guy that is just so special. He knows that he can achieve anything. He has already been the champion. He has got nothing left to prove. And the only reason he carries on is to prove something to himself.
A tip. Oh, excuse me.
Will you look at that? Will you look at that? Don Charles raking the eye. Raking the eyes of Spud on the outside.
Sorry, I sneezed there, John. I got a little bit on my shoe, which I had to clean off. What were you saying about Don Charles? Is he back at ringside again?
I'm saying, much like yourself, Gilligan Gordon, he is a pathetic individual.
Hey, listen up, Tubby. You start calling me pathetic when you've got a stank to hold it with. Look at Dave Morales. He can call you pathetic any day of the week, because to him, you are. You're a waste of space.
Look how good Spud is. Look how close he came to pinning Dave Morales just a moment or two ago. Imagine what it'd be like if Charming Don Charles wasn't sticking his oar in at every 5 minutes on the outside of the ring.
I have yet to see Don Charles interfere in a single contest.
That's what you've got, perpetual hay fever. Bad eyes, contact lenses falling out. You've got an excuse for every occasion, Gilligan Gordon. You're a pathetic waste of space. But Spud is determined to win. He is determined to fight back. He is determined to bring himself dragging and screaming back into this matchup.
There's only so much I can take from you, John. You started to make this personal, claiming that I'm some kind of, what's the word, someone that thinks they're ill all the time.
Hypochondriac, that's what you are.
Yes, one of those. You're trying to accuse me of that, but I'm not. Just like Spud. Spud's a hypochondriac. This is what one looks like, making excuses.
Maybe this time, but no. Planted.
No satellite DDT.
Planted on the top. Planted on the top rope there.
What the?
And Morales by the hair.
God!
Look at the strength. Look at the power of the human hate machine. There's no way a normal man would get out of that, but Spud does.
Don't. Come on. Dave Morales was chief there. Spud pulled his hair back.
Are you taking the mick or something, Gordon? Spud was just yanked from the top turnbuckle to the middle of the ring by his hair, by the human hate machine, and he still manages to kick out.
He cheated. He pulled Dave Morales' hair. And now, Spud, no doubt, the little hypochondriac will have an excuse for why he's in a sleeper hold now.
You tell me there's not something special about this guy, Spud. You tell me he's not one of the most celebrated athletes in SAS history.
Oh, he's as special as you are, John. Stop throwing that word around. You want to see special? Look at the sadistic Jack Storm. There is a special man, a special athlete, the only man deserving of the SAS UK heavyweight title.
Well, referee Joel Allen checking Spud out there. He is still waving his left leg about fervently, but has he got enough in the tank to get back to a vertical base? Can he get back up to his feet? Can he break out of that sleep hold?
Well, here you see Joel Allen, the referee, the afro, encouraging Spud, not disqualifying him for pulling the hair. And
referee Joel Allen is calling it right down the middle. Spud did manage to get back up to his feet. But again, as I said before, the size difference too great. A single blow there from the human hate machine, and Spud back on the canvas.
Definitely, you called it exactly as I saw it. Dave Morales hit him in the back of the head, and down he went again. Look at Morales now, muscling Spud back up to his feet. This man just puts on such impressive displays all of the time, trying to grind his face off, take out his eye sockets, and it's all legal if you ask me.
Well, no one is asking you, and indeed referee Joel Allen giving him the count of five to break the hold, and Spud is in the most delicate position indeed. He is very close to falling out of the ring.
He's right where he needs to be, cowering away, trying to scuttle to the back, John.
He is draped in that bottom rope, and quite frankly, Joel Allen should have physically pulled off the human hate machine. And now, Charming Don Charles with that cane again! I'm getting deja vu! He is just raking the eye! He is pulling the hair!
Would you have chosen this colour scheme, John? Would you have gone,
oh, don't be ridiculous, look at the monitor for once! Look at the monitor for once!
I'm still trying to cower and get away. I do like the decor here, John. It's very nice.
The Wolverhampton Civic Hall is a fantastic venue. We've already spoke of its story and history, but I thank you to concentrate on the match at hand. And now Don Charles distracting the referee. And the human hate machine with a big closed fist.
Oh, that was unfortunate. If you notice, he sort of reflexed and his hand closed as he made impact with Spud's jaw. I don't think it was intentional. The human hate machine wouldn't do that.
The human hate machine just did do it. A big closed right fist to the jaw of Spud.
No.
And Spud may have a dislocated jaw from that one.
Probably cracked, maybe fractured, but again, it was an accident.
Nothing accidental about what's going to happen, though. You can see human hate machine Dave Morales just readying himself, just getting himself in a perfect position.
Can we see the clothesline of hate? That deadly lariat of Dave Morales's.
Spud now in a bad place. Kick to the midsection.
The Tiger Driver.
Hooks the arms.
Yes.
Spud's up. No. He is fighting back.
There was a closed fist.
It was all he could do to get out of the hold.
And you're condoning it?
Oh, and a knee there from Morales. Turns everything back round again.
In the favour of the hate machine. Spud now about to get written off. Oh, no.
Spud ducks a flurry of clothesline from Morales. And he comes off fighting. He comes off the middle rope fighting. Goes for a big drop kick. Morales is down. He's back up to his feet again, though. And Spud cannot afford to let up for a single instant.
Oh!
Beautiful wheelbarrow bulldog hooks the leg. Here's the cover.
Kick two. It's a very calculated two count there by Dave Morales. Just allowing himself that extra time to get his win back.
Indeed, Dave Morales did kick out on two there. But how close did Spud come to walking away with a victory?
Not close at all.
He came very close indeed, and he can sense it. He can sense that he's put in so much hard work. Maybe now it's about to pay off. He can't afford to take his eyes off Morales for 1 second, though.
Oh,
and indeed a rake to the eye. And I think the referee must have seen that, surely. Nonetheless, he lets it go.
Spud holding on like a coward. Oh!
Rolls down the bottom rope. Morales to the outside. Lands hard on the floor.
What cheap actions now by Spud. What cheap, disgusting. What is he signalling for? This is illegal, referee. Disqualify him.
I'll tell you exactly what he's signalling for. This is fantastic. Spud sensing the opportunity to put Dave Morales.
Oh my God!
Flies over the top rope. He flew over the top rope.
Is Dave okay? It's a get those security guards back out. Get medical help. Dave, get up. Come on.
Oh. Is Spud okay? He sacrificed his own body to take out Morales. Both men are down.
To hell with Spud. It was his own fault anyway if he did.
Both men are down.
Come on. Dave, get back up.
Spud nonetheless burst back up to his feet. But has he even got the strength to bring Morales back into the ring?
If you ask me, it's a mistake. Dave's going to get back up and he's going to finish him. I just know it.
Spud rolls the human hate machine back into the ring. He's shown superhuman strength. But he is signaling he needs to do one more thing.
No.
He is climbing up to the top turnbuckle.
Come on. Come on, Dave. You can destroy him.
Morales gets to his feet.
Oh.
Spud jumps right over, lands on his feet. It's called German suplex.
Yes, it's over. One, two, three.
Spud kicked out this month.
Come
Jake
on.
Kicked out last time. No. Oh my!
The same time. One, two, three.
And again, no. Spud kicks out. Again, Spud gets the shoulder up. Somehow, Spud kicks out.
Referee, that was three. Come on! Oh, this is ridiculous. How could Spud keep doing this?
Somehow the matchup continues. Somehow the contest goes on. Dave Morales back up to his feet. He is scratching his head. Don Charles on the outside, close to tears. They just don't know what they've got to do to put the man away.
He's going for the Tiger Driver again. This will be the end. This will be the finish. Do it, Dave. Ruin him. End him.
Spud's struggling to get back up to his feet, but he doesn't know what awaits him. A kick to the guts. You're right, he's hooking the arms back again for that Tiger Driver.
Yes.
But no.
How does Spud do this?
Morales doesn't have the strength, clearly.
That's it, good.
Yes. Yes. He's hooked it. It's over.
He has hooked the arm for a second time.
No.
They pull him back too far. He misjudged the weight of Spud. Spud with a kick to the back of the head. Morales is down. Spud going to the ropes again.
Get up, mate. Dave, you can't keep letting this ignorant, angry little rat do this to you!
Morales is going nowhere. Morales is down. That kick to the back of the head knocked him right out.
No!
Comes at the top.
No.
Frog splash! Frog splash!
No!
Hooks the leg.
No. One,
two, three! No! Did he get it?
No.
So close.
No, only two! Only two, John!
Unbelievable!
Only two!
Unbelievable! These two men have given it everything they've got.
Come on, Dave! Get up, Dave, you can do it!
Right here in SAS, that's where you will see this kind of action.
No, this isn't action, this is a travesty, it's a farce!
Both these men have given everything they possibly could.
Oh,
both have kicked out move after move. But it's Morales who is down, and it is Spud who is just tuning up. He is just getting ready. He's teased it a couple of times already, and he missed it on that occasion. Oh, wow! Release German suplex right into the turnbuckle.
Overhead! Yes! Tiger!
Oh, that's got to be it.
One, two, three!
No! No way! No, sir!
Don't believe it!
You don't believe it! I'm gobsmacked!
You will be if you carry on! What the hell? Dave, control the hate! Just finish him off!
I think that might be it. That might be it. You said control the hate. I think Dave Morales is losing his focus. He's getting angry. He's done so much to put Spud away, but it's been ineffectual so far.
Call it! Call it and hit it! Bring up the clothesline of hate, Dave! Finish the job! Take his head clean off his body!
Spud's still down. Morales back on his feet.
Yes! Yes, here it comes! Clothesline of hate, the elbow pads off!
The elbow
here
pad is
the head!
He is just winding up that arm. Spud's still down. Spud's still struggling even to get back up to his feet.
Why doesn't Spud just quit? Why do you have to put yourself through this?
Because he hasn't got an ounce of quit in his body.
Well, here it comes. It's about to be impotent.
Oh, my goodness.
Good luck.
Oh, he dumped it. He dumped the clothesline.
What the?
Here it is, the satellite from PT. Morales is down.
Who's
coming?
No.
It's all over.
No.
It's all over. victory for Spud. He has defeated the Human Hate Machine once and for all.
No! No, they didn't win. It's Shoulder. He kicked the floor. The ropes are out. God, no!
And there is a man who is destroyed. There is a man who is destroyed. He has got nothing. Charming Don Charles, his man has lost. The Human Hate Machine was down. It was so close, but Spud, he ducked the clothesline of hate. He got back up and he caught from nowhere. Morales came off the road. Spud, very lucky, but he got that satellite DDT. He has put away so many people with it. And you can add Dave Morales to that list right now.
No! John, you're lying. You're lying to the people. They didn't just see that. Dave Morales is unstoppable. He's a hate machine. He hates people. He doesn't lose.
You saw it as well as I did. Dave Morales was down and out for the 1-2-3. There is your winner, the little man with the big heart, the former SAS UK Wrestling Champion, and the man who will be taking on Charming Don Charles in a Bring Your Jeans street fight, Spud.
Where do you find out this information, John? How do you know these things? It didn't happen. None of this happens. You're lying. You're lying to the people. Dave Morales won. Team Charming won.
Live in denial all you like, but that won't take anything away from the victory of Spud here tonight. Maximum Impact 2007 Elite Uprising. What a show. What a night. This has been a great night so far, and the action is only going to continue.
Oh, Team Charming will come back. Jack Storm will finish Martin Stone the way Dave Morales should have finished Spud. Oh, damn it! I just don't know what to say. What am I supposed to say?